Hi, this is going to be a quick segment that we can do on the floor. I have a set of 3-pound dumbbells. We're going to focus on chest, abdomen, back, and a little bit of leg. Perhaps some tricep too. So, let's just start off with your general warm-up. We're just going to do a quick set of push-ups. So I'm modified. I'm on my knees. Pull my hips in, tummy tight. My hands are at the lower portion of my chest. Drop and press up. Just a quick little warm-up here. 2, 3, exhale on your way up. Draw the belly button in. 7, 8, 9, 10, and 12. Reach back, stretch. Come back forward. Now, I'm going to start off with a 3-pound dumbbell. I want a neutral pelvis, so I'm lining up my hip bones. With the pubic bone, and you want to imagine that you have like metal rods from your hips to the floor, keeping you stable. So I'm going to start off going out to the side with my weight. So my left arm is slightly bent. I'm going to lift out to the side. I am working right now my abdomen and my rear delts, as well as my upper back and abs. I'm not rotating, I'm not rolling. I'm keeping everything square. Now to make it a little bit more challenging, I'm going to extend my left leg out. Continue to draw the hips in, and continue to lift out to the side. Exhaling as you lift. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, switching sides. Out to the other side. Hips are square. Slight bend in my right elbow. Exhale to the lift. Make it a little bit more challenging now. Extend my right leg out. Keep the hips square. Working through the abdomen, upper back, rear delts. Exhale on the lift. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, now I'm going to put my dumbbells in both hands. And then we're going to do what's called an alternating Superman. So, basically, you're going to lift the right arm, left leg, and come down, and switch sides. And come down. Now you can do this with or without weights. You want to squeeze the abdomen, squeeze the glutes. You want to imagine that you have a ball placed at the small of your back. So the ball is right here. So when you go to extend, you don't want the hips rolling. Keep everything nice and straight. Imagine that you have a ball between your shoulder blades as well. So it's exhale, inhale, exhale. Keep drawing the belly button up to the spine. Nice and balanced. This hits shoulders, triceps, abs, glutes, low back. So if you want to hit a lot of exercises really quick, maybe you only have 5 or 10 minutes, this is a great exercise to do. Hit the floor. We're going to switch that to lift out to the side again. Still feeling the glutes connect. Feel those abs kicking in. Keep going. Let's go 4 more. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Set the weights off to the side. Stretch to the back again. Walk those fingers forward. Then let's stretch the chest. So open the chest, roll the shoulders back, pull in the abdomen. And let's just finish up with some quick crunches. So, switching your feet around to the front. Hands on the shin, imprint. So you're rolling through the back, one vertebra at a time. Okay, here again, going in a neutral pelvis, lining up your hip bones and the pubic bone in the same plane. Okay, or if you have low back problems, you may want to imprint or push your low back down. Either way, you're drawing your belly button to the spine. So here's neutral, you get more bang for your buck here, or imprint, neutral. And as you do a crunch, you're lifting your shoulder blades off the floor. Controlling the head motion. You don't want to be yanking on the head. That's bad for your neck. And it's not working your abs either. So here, by doing the basic crunch, balancing a cup of water on your tummy, you are holding a neutral pelvis and you're working internal and external obliques, as well as your transverse abdominis, which is like a seatbelt that goes all the way around you. Exhale on your lift. You're driving your rib cage to the hips. Four more. Three, two, and one. And then you can go side to side. So this hits a little bit more oblique. Again, if you have low back issues, it's okay to start off in an imprint and then do your crunches side to side, but you're not going to get as much out of the actual exercise as if you were to go back to neutral pelvis. And sometimes this is going to, if this is new to you, it's going to be very uncomfortable until your body gets used to neutral pelvis, which is where we should be with for a perfect spine, at least in the lower component, because you got to worry about the upper body too. But this is your basic crunch. You can always throw in something different, like a little bit of a knee lift, alternating, turn it, rotate it, or go straight up. But the most important thing to remember when you do a neutral pelvis is if you were to imagine that you had a cup of tea or water sitting on your tummy, a cup of water, you don't want to spill it. So no matter what you do, if you're kicking your legs, if you're doing a straight leg lift, whatever it is that you're doing, balance that cup of water and you'll get more bang for your buck when you do your abs. Okay, so those are a couple quick tips for you to work those abdominals.